just starting off our video, what is the weakness policy? Well, the weakness policy is a very, very simple and straightforward item. If our Pokemon gets it with a super effective hit, and it survives the hit, the weakness policy will activate, giving our Pokemon 2 stat increases into both attack and special attack. So, that's pretty much it. That is pretty much all there is to the weakness policy. But the question is, how do we use it? I mean, it's pretty straightforward. We take a weakness policy item, we strap it onto a Pokemon. If it gets hit with a super effective move, it will get a stat increase into both its attack and special attack. But the question most people ask is, how do I use it? I think I've repeated the question now twice, but the question still remains, how? Well, out of all the Pokemon across all the generations, it doesn't really matter which one you put it on. The real question is, will the Pokemon be able to make use of the item better than, say, if they were going to use a Life Orb or something? It all depends on what their moves are, what their abilities are, what they're trying to do, their basic stats, and so on. Can they support having a weakness policy and afford taking that super effective hit? So, a Pokemon that would make really good use of a weakness policy is a Pokemon with an ability that would, say, decrease an opponent's attack stat, like, say, an Intimidator, such as Arcanine. Arcanine has some really good stats. It has some really strong defensive stats, an 80 in both, and it would probably be the best Pokemon to make use of a weakness policy, simply because the Intimidate will lower the opponent's attack stat, which will make their attacks weaker. And if they try to go for a super effective hit on Arcanine, well, he's already weakened their attack enough so that he will most definitely survive, as long as it's not like a Groudon's Precipice Blades hit. As long as he weakens the attack, and as long as it's like a physical attack super effective hit that he's weak to, then he can pretty much survive and make use of the weakness policy. So that is one way to make use of the weakness policy. Another way to make use of the weakness policy is on a Pokemon that has a combo of move and ability that it's going to be used, such as the Sturdy ability and, say, something along the lines of Rock Polish or Automatize. A Pokemon such as Steelix. Steelix has access to the Automatized move, which will give it an increase in speed of about 2 stages, as well as make it lighter. So that's one way it can do that. So it also has a really, really strong physical defensive stat. And it also has access to the ability Sturdy. And since it has Sturdy, it will survive that super effective hit regardless of what type of move it hits it. So if it's a physical attacking move, well, we have ourselves a weakness policy Pokemon. It's going to survive regardless. It uses a move that will increase its speed, and it's even got a move that will, you know, make it lighter if it wants to. So that is another way we can use the weakness policy. Basically using it to give more power to a Pokemon that's going to take a turn to set up anyway. So you might as well take that chance and get the weakness policy off. That's why Sturdy Steelix and even Sturdy Skarmory are very good Pokemon to use the weakness policy on. So the next Pokemon we're trying to look at is one that uses an ability that raises its defensive stats in some way. A Pokemon with the Sandstream abilities such as Gigalith. So what does Gigalith do? Gigalith has access to the Sandstream ability. And for those who don't know, the Sandstream will increase the special defense by 50%. So it's already got a really strong defense stat, it has a really strong attack stat, it has a decent special defense stat, and it's super slow. So if we give our Sturdy Pokemon, or not the Sturdy Pokemon, if we give the Sandstream to the Gigalith, and give it the weakness policy, we're guaranteed to at least survive one hit. So we don't even need to go for a setup move. We can go straight for the attack, since we know for sure we're gonna take a super effective hit. So we might as well use that stat boost increase as much as possible, since we're already super slow. We're not gonna move super fast with Gigalith. But he has access to some very powerful moves, and if he gets that power boost increase, well, all the more power to him. He can take a hit with that Sandstream. He can take a really strong hit. He can take a lot of damage. The next Pokemon we're going to be looking at for the weakness policy is a very popular one, and it's going to be the Aegislash. And the reason why we're going for the Aegislash is because, well, We know that Aegislash is a really strong defensive Pokemon, at least when it's in shield form. So if it's in shield form, those massive 150 base stats for both defense and special defense means it's gonna take a lot to take it down. So even in shield form, it's gonna take, you know, one hit at the very least. So a weakness policy onto the Aegislash that, you know, can at least absorb that hit and then counter with a +2 in both attack and special attack, that's a really strong Pokemon. This is where the weakness policy shines. It shines on increasing powerful Pokemon that, you know, that can take a hit and can deal the damage as well. You don't want to put it on a really weak Pokemon such as, say, Miss Magius. So while Miss Magius might make good use of the special attack increase, it's really poor defensive stats and though it has a really good special defense stat, it's really weak defensive stat means it's not gonna be able to survive a physical hit that it's weak to. It just doesn't have the stats to make use of the weakness policy. You need a Pokemon that has like an average defense and special defense between the two stats. So that is where the weakness policy, when you want to make use of it. Pokemon that have really good, that have a really good stat in, or have average stats in defenses, or an ability that will protect them and ensure they get that weakness policy off and can make use of it. A weakness or an ability that will, you know, increase their defenses in some way so they can make use of the weakness policy, and has an attack or a special attack to back up the weakness policy uses, and a Pokemon that can swap between really powerful attacks and really strong defenses at a moment's notice. So that is how you make use of the weakness policy. That is when you want to make use of it. Using it on a Pokemon, just any Pokemon, is not really how you want to be using it. You want to use it to basically set up an already strong Pokemon, whether it's a tank or a really strong offensive Pokemon. That is how you want to make use of the weakness policy. Setting them up, making sure that they get that weakness policy off and can, you know, make good use of it in some way. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video, and I thank you all for watching. I will see you tacticians next time. Bye-bye.